All right, hello guys and girls. Welcome to another video on the YouTube channel. Today's video is gonna be an honest Q&A. So recently I did put a little poll up on my Instagram story to kind of gauge what you guys are feeling, what kind of content you wanna see. Obviously the most popular option was a Q&A with the mum, but obviously we're both working people. So we're gonna have to get that arranged at some point, but it will be coming soon. And yeah, the second most popular option was an honest Q&A video. Did get quite a few questions in, which I do appreciate. Without further ado, enough chitter-chatter, let's get on with it. So the first question is actually four questions from at Louis Duffy _. He came into the DMs hot with some requests. How tall are you? What's your middle name? Got any pets? And what's your dream job? So I'm 188 centimeters, which is 6'1" pushing into 6'2". My middle name is actually Rex. I will put a proof just on the video somewhere. I don't know where it's gonna go. Do I have any pets? Yes, I have one pet. I've got a cat called Pretzel. I did used to have a cat called Popcorn, but unfortunately she did die when I was about 17, I wanna say, 17, 18. So yeah, that was unfortunate, but we still got one hanging in there, luckily. And what is your dream job? Pretty simple guy, really. Basketball is my passion, always has been. My dream job is just to play professionally at the best level I can. You know, maybe down the line, I would consider, let's say during retirement, to become a motivational speaker, a sports journalist, any form of punditry. And yeah, that's me, really, all his life. The second question comes in from Alexander _Fifi1, and he asks, how do you deal with the awkward dating stage with slow replies? Now, first things first, there can be a few reasons why we're getting slow replies. Not necessarily you, Alex, that could just be anyone. But from my opinion, the main reason why you might be getting slow replies is because they're not that interested in getting to know you as you thought they might be. There's two ways to really go about it. You can either confront it to the person and just be straight up and ask, look, like, what are you on? Do you want to get to know me? Or the other thing, which I tend to do a lot as well, is distance myself from the conversation. You got to understand, like, when I'm dating, it's never my number one priority. I've already got a life for myself, whether it's basketball, gym, working, family time, friend time. Like, I'm sweet. Obviously, dating is something I enjoy doing, but at the same time, I don't rely on it so much for my happiness. So I feel like the best ways to deal with those awkward moments where you feel like you're not getting the responses you want or it's not going the way you want it, rather than overthinking it and getting into your emotions about it, just ask the person straight up, let's cut the bullshit here. Do you want to get to know me or not, kind of thing. Next question is from at Ed Medcalf. Top five players in the league right now. Damn, top five. In no particular order, I would say Giannis, Luka Doncic, Steph Curry, KD, and Nikola Jokic. So Giannis, I'd say head and shoulders above the rest right now. What he's doing on both ends of the court, he's just a force to be reckoned with. Absolute monster. Luka Doncic as well, 23 years old, I think. He's tearing up the league. You know, the last few years, he's really put the league on notice and he just makes the game look effortless. So Luka's in there for sure. Steph Curry, obviously, many of you don't watch basketball would know him. An absolute icon of the game, changed the game, shoots that ball effortlessly, real smooth player. And the last couple of years in particular, he's really shown he is the man. So yeah, Steph's definitely in there. Number four, I put KD. He's one of the best scorers I think I've ever seen in my life. He's a 7-footer, plays like a guard, can pretty much do anything. So I would put KD in there for sure. And my fifth one is Nikola Jokic. Back-to-back MVP the last two seasons. It's a triple-double machine. With him on the floor, the Denver Nuggets are a winning team. And again, like a player like Doncic, you know, being from a European background, he's bringing that style into the NBA and he's dominating. One of the most efficient players I've ever seen. I will have to also shout out some honorable mentions that just miss out. Obviously, LeBron James. Don't get me wrong, what he's doing at 37 is unheard of. Forever going to be in the GOAT conversation, on the Mount Rushmore for sure of all-time greats in the game. But I think LeBron is coming to the end of his productive years and it really just comes down to that. And obviously there's other players, you know, the likes of Donovan Mitchell for Cleveland has been tearing up the league. Jason Tatum at the Celtics, you know, he's been playing at an MVP standard this season. Ja Morant, obviously killing the league as well. There's just so many talented players. Shout out to Embiid as well, obviously, killing it. Yeah, my top five would be Giannis, Doncic, Steph, KD and Jokic. Next question is from at Angela Katamari, I think it is. And she asked, how much do you miss me? Now, I wish I could answer that, but I don't really know you. So, yeah, I'll just leave it at that. Question five, at That's Fatal with two L's. Top five music artists. I would say number one, Kanye West. Despite all the controversy surrounding him, no one can deny he's an absolute genius with music. Number two, I'd probably have to say Drake. Just for like the last 10 years, he's always been at the top. I would argue his earlier albums, like, you know, Take Care, Nothing Was the Same, If You're Reading This Too Late. That's where he was at his peak, but he still managed to maintain that level in terms of viewership. Yeah, Drizzy's in there, number two. Number three, I'd say Post Malone. Post Malone's someone I've followed very closely over the years since he kind of started with Stony. And it's had a massive impact, you know, on my experience with music. You know, I think he's a top artist, very talented, and a very down-to-earth, humble guy. So, yeah, Posty's in there for sure. And number four would be Coldplay. I just think they're an electric band, man. The music they produce is just sensational. They've been doing it for so long now, you know, the longevity is crazy. So I think that alone deserves recognition, but they're number four for me. Some great albums over the years. And number five, throwing it back a bit, I'm going to go with Oasis. Cemented in British culture. The working class man can relate heavily to Oasis music. Just a wicked band, man. Rock and roll. Yeah, Oasis make the fifth spot for me. Question six is from @DanKent89. What's your dream place / country to visit? If you asked me this 3 years ago, I would have probably said LA, only because I was in love with the idea of going to Venice Beach to play basketball. But I think LA is a little bit shaky nowadays. The celebrity status out there is crazy. Like, I don't think I'd manage to cope with people going around banging on about Instagram likes, fame, TikTok views, etc. Doesn't feel like a very authentic world to me. Oh, that's tricky. I've always wanted to travel to Asia, which I am planning to do. I think it's just such a beautiful region of the world. I know people who have gone, they've had a great time, they've come back with life-changing experiences, so yeah, that would be nice. I'd also like the idea of going to like Mauritius, the Maldives, Bahamas, just a group of islands, tropical islands. That to me feels like paradise. I would probably say my dream place would be like a group of islands, just anywhere. I'm not really that fussy to go like Maldives, Mauritius. The list goes on, man. Okay, question seven is from @jharrison2298, and he asks, who was your favorite co-worker at Nando's in Canterbury and why? So yeah, in case you didn't know, while I was studying at uni, I did work at the Nando's up in Canterbury. Yeah, I worked there for a good 2.5 years. I would say my favourite co-worker was probably Toyin. You know, she was just a gem, straight up. Always brought a positive vibe to the workplace. She was very funny. She didn't take life too seriously, and she always went about things the right way, in my opinion. So me and Toyin got very close through the years, and you know, that friendship still continues to this day. If you are watching this, Toyin, big up yourself. Question eight is from @gingershavesouls2_. What is your life like with a little brother? You gotta change that name, bro. Seriously, that was a ball ache to read. But no, life with a little brother is cool, man. Being a big brother, I do often feel like I have a duty of responsibility to set the example, you know, look after you wherever I can, give you advice on anything you need. Hopefully I'm doing that. But nah, having a little brother's cool, man. We get along, we give each other our own space. We both play basketball now. Obviously, I've been teaching you a little bit, hoping to get you trained up properly. You know, it's just all vibes, man. Question nine is from @ali.alizard300, and he asked, what's my opinion on weed? I got nothing against weed, man. People have their reasons to use whatever they use or consume whatever they consume. Do they have anxiety? Does it help them relax? Does it help them perform better in whatever job they're doing? It might not work for everyone, but you can clearly see that there is some positive research behind weed. It's only bad when you really become over-reliant on it to the point where it's getting in the way of other areas of your life. But I think if you're doing it under moderation, you've got it under control, and you feel like you're making the most of that experience, then why not? You know, why not? Next question is from @MatthewMully487, and he asks, what's my favourite sports person? So without a shadow of a doubt, favourite sports person of all time is Kobe Bryant. Unbelievable player. His approach to the game, his winning mindset, his insane work ethic, his attitude towards life inspired me so much, man. It's crazy. I've even got his book, The Mamba Mentality, Kobe Bryant book. Really good book, you know, it discusses everything you'd want to know about how to reach the top level of basketball, the NBA, etc. Anyone who follows basketball closely knows that Kobe was the real deal. Not even just as a player, but as a man. My God. Kobe Bryant, and whatever he did, he applied himself like no other man would, and you can only be inspired by him. Rest in peace, Kobe, man. Forever missed, but we'll always remember you for what you've done. The penultimate question is from @BarneyPitt_. Do you have a new perspective on life after your head injury? So if you haven't seen on my previous video, I discussed what happened last summer where I essentially slit my head open by hitting it on a rock and I nearly died from it. And my answer to that is absolutely. When you're going through a moment like that where you're on the brink of death and you come out of it on the better end, changes everything, man. And it's a real eye-opener that, you know, you only live once. I definitely came out of that feeling a whole lot of gratitude towards life. you just come out of that and think like, damn, I was that close to death and yet here I am still here telling my story to you guys. You do come out of it as a different person. You learn from your mistakes, you learn from your experiences, and you just keep moving forward. And the final question is from @sam.ce, and he asked, what's the lowest moment in your life and how did you deal with it? Now, there's two moments that stick out in my mind and they're both linked to the same thing. The first lowest moment was during COVID, where I actually did upload a mental health awareness video on my Instagram, which discussed my depression, how I felt isolated, lonely, all the wrong negative feelings. And the second time is what I'm going through right now, actually, with my knee problems. So for the past 3-4 years, I've had really bad knee pains, but I've played through it. Every game I've gone into, I've felt hesitant. It's always a risk. I could make it worse. And ultimately, I have made it worse. As a result, I am going to have to sit out from basketball, hence why I've started this YouTube channel. I'm not going to lie, it's a shit feeling. When you're forced out of doing the things you love, you know, playing the game I love, it's very hard to get over that hurdle. And obviously with my mental health awareness video, a lot of that was linked to my knee problems. You know, I had crazy ambitions to play basketball that year in particular, but deep down I also knew that I had my knee problems that I wasn't really addressing at the time. But ultimately the way I've dealt with all of this is just accepting, like, this is my life now. You know, the longer you put it off, the longer you try and force your way through it, the worse you're just going to turn out ultimately. It's just a bitter pill to swallow. You know, you've just got to crack on with life, do what you've got to do, and you will come out of it as a better person. And I've ultimately just accepted, you know, this feeling of depression or just my mental health problems, it's always going to be there with me. Basketball was my way of escaping it, but ultimately I can't play basketball at the moment. The way I deal with it is just take the necessary steps and understand that yes, it might be shit in this moment in time, but if you take the right steps and do the right things for you, then you will come out of it as a stronger person and you will go on to achieve your dreams. And that's what I firmly believe, so that's what gives me hope each and every day when I'm feeling low. Yeah, so that's all the questions, guys. Thank you very much for listening. If any of this did help any of you guys, then that always makes me feel better. So just drop a comment down below if you did feel touched or motivated or found any of this entertaining. But you know the drill, guys. Like, comment, subscribe, all that jazz. And I'll catch you guys soon.